Good evening. Good morning. Hello. Au revoir. Brothers, ni hao. Ni hao ma. And my Mandarin brothers. Konnichiwa. Oshiromastai. To my Japanese brothers. What's up? To all my brothers, African brothers around the world. Fraternity brothers. We want to just say, first and foremost, we love you and we praise God for you. And I say we, I mean the Holy Spirit, myself, I believe we all one, and I believe I'm part of the big Trinity. The Trinity, the people of God. And as I'm doing this video right now on this day, making sure I get close to the microphone. Sorry for that change of the page. I'm using my 1080p Apple Mac here. And I want to just talk because this is a great day. And as I get close, I want you to hear me clearly. This is a great day. Great one day we'll never see before. A great day we'll never see again. For a select individual group of mine that I treasure so much. Out of Oklahoma. There are many Bible schools out here. Many ministries. And one of them that the Lord let me go to was due to my spiritual father and his father, my grandfather. And it was Word of Faith International Christian Center out of Detroit, Michigan, under Bishop Keith A. Butler. A Word of Faith term came from a man named Kenneth E. Hagin, Sr., on my right-hand screen. And as you type in that word, and I want you to see it for the video, for those that are brand new that don't know about the last 100 years of Christian ministry and are baby Christians and go to different churches, hungry for the things of God, but are not knowing where to go. I want to definitely say there's a place. There's a place. There's a place. Hallelujah. Where the Lord will show you who you are and teach you things that you may never thought you needed to know. It's a tough place because this is a place of growing, a place of development, a place of spiritual disciplines, a place of seriousness. And if you come into this place right, and you stay focused and do 4 years, your whole life, as I feel the presence of God coming to me right now with my body and know Jesus Christ is here, will be with you 25 years later. I went to this place 24 years ago, 2001, as the situation in my life, like many of y'all's, loss of loved ones, family, friends, making life changes, changing jobs, going places you never thought you'd go. And in that place, in that time, and me doing that thing, I had the opportunity to meet Dad Hagin. He was 83 years old, and I call him Dad, as we call him affectionately Dad, but he would really be my great-granddad, if you don't want to think about it. He was 83, and I'm 25. I'm a young kid. Just turned 26 in that October, and 2 years later, he's going to glory. Within that 2 years, we have 9/11. We lost thousands of people by airplanes and towers. And we have thousands of people lost in wars of 20 years from that moment. So from my life, I can definitely say my particular BCAD experience, like millions of people around the world who've seen, for example, Pearl Harbor and the next calamity that's soon to come and the next one that y'all will see and we'll see. And you'll say the same thing from now, 25 years from now. But for this generation, while we have our men and women alive before they graduate on and go on to glory, I wanted to say thank you. The son of Dad Hagin is right now 80 plus years old. His days are numbered. And like all of our days are numbered. Ecclesiastes teaches us as a day to be born, a day to die, a day to plant, a day to sow, time to be born, time to be happy, sad. Time for war, time for peace. Everything that we're happening and going through right now on this earth, the Bible already talked about and teaches us. And if we read the word, we'll be that much ahead of the curve and not be caught by the winds of doctrine, of false doctrine. We will be able to be smart Christians. Revelation chapter 2 in King James Version, which I only read as I show here on the side, was a church that was in, quote unquote, Turkey, Ephesus. The name of the church is the Church of Ephesus. This is a church that was not with Hebrew Israelites, not with people that knew those scriptures thousands of years ago. They were already in the curse. We were in the curse of the law. But, and that's Deuteronomy chapter 28. But this was for the new converts that accepted Yah. And when I say Yah, I'm talking about Yahweh through his son Yeshua and the precious Holy Spirit, and started being told by the great apostle John in this powerful revelation. Things that he saith that he holdeth seven stars in Yah's right hand, who walketh in the midst of the seven golden candlesticks. We call that a menorah, those that understand that in practice. Yahshua said, I know thy works, thy labor, thy patience, and how thou cannot bear them which are evil. And thou hast tried them which say they are apostles and are not, and hast found them liars. Has borne, has patience, and for my name's sake has labored, has not fainted. Nevertheless, I have somewhat aught against thee, because thou have left thy first love. Remember therefore from whence you art fallen, and repent, and do the first works that you had. This is the basic beginning. Go back, or else I will come unto you quickly, and I remove thy candlestick out of his place. Notice this, his place. I mean, those seven golden candlesticks, one of them is us. He will remove it if we don't repent. But this thou hast, that thou hatest the deeds, and it broke down the Nicolaitans, which I also hate, another group of people. We can use the deeds of LGBTQ, the deeds of other groups of people out there, and there's lots of groups. But then verse 7, but he or she that hath an ear to this knowledge, let him or her hear what the Spirit says unto the churches. To him or her that overcometh, will I give thee a tree of life, the tree of life in the midst of the paradise of God. Well, we all do this thing, and this thing called Jesus, this thing called RHEMA, this knowledge, which RHEMA really means spoken word. So it's not about a ministry, it's not about a person. What it is about is the person of Yahshua, Jesus, and that all of us are going to meet. And as that Bible's being held up, representing that, we want to make sure we understand that today, of course, is graduations, second week of graduations for many, 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 many churches across the world. And I'm now finding there's Bible schools now are coming up, and just found out Kenneth Copeland has a Bible school now, and he's in his 80s, about the same age as yours truly. And he's decided to start a Bible school a few years ago. Everyone's got Bible schools. So now with all these different Bible schools, therefore, it's going to be very much a division amongst the body of Christ in tomorrow's world of where do you go? Who do you go? Who do you follow? Who do you follow? And the biggest thing I want to say about RHEMA that I love so much compared to Oral Roberts, compared to Kenneth Copeland, compared to Southwestern Believers, compared to so many Bible schools out across the country, and I'm a future seminarian, want to be a doctor of divinity, a doctor of ministry, I can say that the key is knowing God, not the school. But the school is important, but the revelation of knowing Yah is the more important. And so today is graduation for the 50th class of RHEMA Bible Training Center that graduated 50 years ago that school was founded. And guess what? Should God tarry, they're going to have the 100th. We won't be here. Hallelujah. But hopefully what we've done will put us in condition and put us in the race that the book of Hebrews talks about us, to be in the great cloud of witnesses and fulfill the will of God for our life. My prayer, my hope for all of us is that the Holy Ghost fire, the fire of God touches everyone. Not only just knowledge of the word, but as we learn when we're in RHEMA, it's the word and it's the Holy Spirit. The fire, the Holy Ghost fire. The sweet Holy Ghost. And they call him the sweet Holy Ghost, but he's also the fire too. A light to the nations, a glorious hope. I will not forget my foundation, the years I spent at RHEMA. I've learned the truth, so I'll carry the flame and I'll go. Never the same. Second verse. I vow this day, the 10th of May, 2024, to lift the banner high and walk in the truth sown into my life. Back to that chorus. It's the word and the spirit, sweet Holy Ghost, light to the nations, glorious hope. I will not forget my foundation. year I spent RHEMA. I've learned the truth, so I'll carry the flame and I'll go. Never the same. 25 years ago, from now you'll be singing those same words. If you did the right thing then and every day from that moment, to never forget that words, those classes, even the textbooks and books you may have lost, go up to the cloud, download them from the cloud, upload them, get the Kindles, but don't stop studying. Get more degrees, get more certifications. RHEMA is not the end. It's just the first step of many steps. Chinese proverb says the journey of 1,000 miles begins with one step. Well, we're on the step 1,000 something, and we got many more thousands of steps to go. Late great Brother Hagin used to talk about this in a book, I Believe in Visions. Great book. Let me show you who he is. When he wrote his book, I Believe in Visions, on the right-hand side, he talked about the 3 times he died and went to hell and exactly what happened in those moments. Then he talked about the 8 times Yeshua came and visited him and had conversations about him and his ministry and his life. And he told us those secrets. And I sat there in that class room in prayer one, prayer two, Holy Ghost, prayer one, prayer one, prayer two. And he was already slowly dying. He was not able even to be in all of our classes. We had to have backups teach in those classes, but he at least would come the first couple of weeks of an eight-week course, and we're doing a quarter system, so we know everything is 8 weeks. And I was blessed because I had just lost my mother earlier that year, 2001. Then 9/11 happened. We lose 4,000, 5,000 people. Then with 2003, we go to Iraq, Afghanistan, war, and then 20-year war. And so my mindset's not focused on my life. It's focused on my God. All these folks lost these souls. But I never forget the day, September 11, 2001, in that auditorium, in that church. And we were sent home, and we watched the second plane hit. We watched the second tower fall, and the first tower fall, and people in New York crying out and screaming out in fear. There wasn't no Donald Trump. There wasn't no I'm Democrat, I'm Republican. It was one United States of America. To the point where Wednesday, that next day, as a black African-American man, never been to a white church before until I went to RHEMA, coming out of a black church, AME Black, African Methodist Episcopal. And today, if you understand anything about church and church history, you understand the breakups and the divisions and denominations that we have within the church that many people live in. And as the fire of the Holy Ghost, I believe, on me and on anybody else who believes, y'all don't like that. He did not like the hatred that we had amongst our people based on our denominations. Just like he doesn't like the hatred that we have on our people based on political affiliations couched under religion. And God's going to judge all of us who try to play both sides of the fiddle. As ministers, we got to be on one side, and that's God's side, against Democrat, against Republican, and against liberal, against Democrat, and against libertarian, all of it. Because in the end of the day, there's no Democrat or democracy in heaven. There's no libertarian in heaven. There is no Republican in heaven. It's only Yeshua HaMashiach, and he is a monarch. Hallelujah. He is the theist. He is a theist. And so, for all my atheist people out there who don't believe, I believe. And I stand on that till the day I die. I'm going to let's play as I go through some of these great things and document this for the video. The word of faith. That is the denomination that I'm a part of. And that is where we are. We're Protestant. Neo-charismatic prosperity theology. And I will honestly say there's errors there. Stand on that. But that doesn't make me run away from it. How did God heal Kenneth A? Through faith and a prayer. Lying bedfast for 16 months. All this is from his own lips. I was there and heard it. Was there controversy? Yes. Is RHEMA Greek or Hebrew? It's Greek. It's a Greek word. And you can see all kinds of questions, man. I mean, these are really good questions. I don't know. All this coming from, of course, Google, which is a, you know, atheist website. But the fact I want you to do is listen to the Son. I just wanted to make sure I put this out because I'm grateful. And I made a video way back in 2022. 6 minute, 11 minute video. And not that many people seen it. I'm Pastor Henry Tyrone from the 404, otherwise known as Pastor Henry Ellis Howard Jr. And I can't believe it because it's been 25 years, but as I look back at my life and I look back at lives of people I know and see God's blessing on their lives that were there, that went to school with me and all of us, even though we may not be in a big-time mega billion-dollar ministry, I'm a network engineer, security engineer, proud, overcome many obstacles, still battling every day, but love the Lord, youth minister, college degrees, accomplished things that my mama never accomplished, my dad never accomplished, my granddad never accomplished, family members of my own that are alive with me never accomplished, but that's all by the glory and the grace of God, and I want to give God the glory, and I want to say congratulations to all the kids, adults, that are walking out their plan that God has for their life. I'm still going to school. I'm still seeking the word. I'm still going to get that DM, Dr. Ministry, and continually up to that. And you should too. And I pray you do. Don't stop. Let's give God the glory.
Love works no ill.
I said love works no ill. Love, we ought to, before we say things sometime, we ought to stop and ask ourselves, how is this going to affect that person? Amen.
In the things familiar, we find security. Resisting all the changes that days and years can bring. When God decides to lead you through an open door, inviting you to walk in.
It's the sound of feet going forth with the good news. Who are these that make this sound of tramp, tramp, tramp as they come, as they go tramping along? Yea, they are those chosen of the Lord, called of God, equipped by His Spirit. They are those who do know their God. They are those who do know His Word. They are those who know the mighty name, the name that's above every name, the name of Jesus. They are those that know how to take that name and break the power of darkness over their lives, the minds, the bodies, the spirits of men, and set them free. Yea, there are those with the message of deliverance, the message of healing, the message of victory, the message of God. Where are they going? They're going unto the uttermost parts of the earth. They're going where an empty hand is reaching out for help. They're going where a hungry cry, hungry for the bread of this life and hungry for the true bread of life, is crying out for help. They're going around the world. to tell the story, to proclaim the message, to do the work that God called them to do. Hallelujah.
For the Lord will go before you into a greater power than you've ever known before. That was me in 2003. Not knowing I was going to be videotaped. I was crying because my mother had passed away just 2 years prior. The one that took care of my family, the one that took care of all of us. And she would not see me walk across that stage. But 3 years before she passed, I knew I was going to go to Bible school, and I told her God was calling me to go to RHEMA. And because of that fact, I am here today. And I will thank God, and I stand on it to the day I die. And I hope you feel that way as a graduate, that the Lord told you to go to that school. And everyone may have said, no, don't go, or say, this is not the will of God. You just say, praise God. As Brother Hagin would say, bless their darling hearts and stupid heads. And you just continue to walk out your faith walk and your faith journey. As the Bible teaches us, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. Work it out with fear and trembling. Work it out with fear and trembling. And that's what we all are doing. And I remember that day like nobody's business, because it was a fast-paced two-year Bible school. And I was so hungry. My mom just passed, and I was blessed with inheritance to go to RHEMA. I don't know if I ever would have went if she had not died. Let's be honest with you. I don't think I could have afforded to make that move. So I know God has miracles and tragedies. I call it miracles and tragedies. Not only miracles can come, but sometimes miracles can come in tragedies. Because she was a born-again believer who loved God and lived for God. And we both got saved in the same time and started walking together and rebuilt our relationship. About 5 years before she went home to be with the Lord at the age of 40, young nine. I'm 49 today. The same age she was when she passed. And I'm on fire for God more than she ever was. And I thank God, because starting at 21 years of age, meeting the Lord, and now 49 years of age, walking with Him, I can tell you, it pays to serve God. And I give glory to all of the men of God that have been in my life, women of God, and people of God. And all the graduates of RHEMA, y'all have those stories as well. Walk on through the door, for the Lord will go before you into a greater power than you've ever known before. This is Pastor St. Tyrone from Beyond the Open Doors Ministries International of Atlanta, Georgia. Using that song has been my song of life by the Gaithers, called Beyond the Open Door. So we give praise that door is not just for me, it's for you, it's for all of us. We all got our doors. Some of those are locked, some are open, some of them God's going to give you a key to open it. As a security engineer, we have what we call encryption, decryption. God's going to give you the ability to encrypt or keep secret your passwords and secrets of the Lord, and then give you the key to decrypt or open up those RHEMA rooms, those ruach, the RHEMA power of God to fulfill God's will for your life. Walk on through the door. Walk on through the door. Hallelujah. Walk on through the door. Amen. Amen.
Jesus answering saith unto them, have faith in God. For verily I say unto you, that whosoever shall say unto this mountain, be thou removed and be thou cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart, but shall believe those things which he saith shall come to pass, he shall have whatsoever he saith. Therefore I say unto you, what things soever ye desire, when ye pray, believe that you receive them, and ye shall have them.
Let's make sure we can't watch him. We're not going to replay or record actual outstanding service that's live. But I will tell you, go online to RHEMA USA. Watch the videos. Study what you hear. Don't just listen. Take notes. Have your Bibles with you. Just because we live in a time of a seeker-friendly church and everybody just thinks it's free to be a Christian, remember that day is coming to an end. Remember the day is coming to an end. Remember, the day is coming to an end where you will not have these easy-peasy Japanese churches. The day is coming that the church of the Lord Jesus Christ will be under attack by those that are haters of Yah. And we're seeing movements happening today amongst different groups of people. And there's many ministers who have fallen away. They did not finish their race and their course with joy, like one of our great ministers, Reverend Carl Pearson, who passed away last year in November. Tragedy of tragedies. Don't be that. Be sober. Be vigilant. Understand this is a war. We're fighting a real devil. We're not here playing around. We're the special force of the kingdom of God. If you don't know what the special forces of the army is, look them up. Same discipline to endure hardness as a good soldier that our soldiers have to endure. You are a soldier now. You are now an elite soldier. Maybe a two-year veteran of just going to RHEMA. That is, doesn't matter. Satan got you marked. You on the mark. You're marked. For killing, you're marked for murder. He wants to kill us. He wants to steal, kill, and destroy. We gotta say we're here, praise God, to fight him with the whole armor of Ephesians chapter 6, all the way down verse 14 to the end of the verse. To know the scriptures, to know them well, and powerfully communicate them to ourselves, then we can minister those to others. Hallelujah. We pray Ephesians prayers over you, Colossians prayers over you. You should know them. You were at RHEMA. You should have been taught. And this is Pastor Saint Tyrone saying, may the Lord richly bless you is our prayer. Congratulations on this Friday. To the next class of 2025, our 51st class that'll be starting in September. We're ready for you, praying for you. Even as a student, we never stop studying. Study to show thyself approved. 2 Timothy 2:15. A workman that needeth not to be ashamed. Rightly. And I missed one big part of that verse, and now the Holy Ghost just told me. Study to show yourself approved unto God. Meaning, not unto me, not unto you, not unto pastor, unto Yah. When you know that God has approved you, you can walk in any house knowing you're strong because you know God has approved you. He will reveal himself to them that he's approved you. The same way he's revealed Yahshua to all of the Sadducees and Pharisees when he walked the earth, that God approved him. But that takes years, time, dedication. It don't come overnight. Study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needeth, or woman, that needeth not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. Things going on in today's church, LGBT, the Methodist church, because they lost so many members now accepting LGBT, these are wrong. And we're going to stand against that stuff. At the same time, it's wrong when people are presidents and using God in religion and politics. That's wrong too. And we stand against that as well. So regardless, if anyone's offended as a minister that knows the word like I am, go to the scriptures, study it out. Because the Holy Ghost is offended at us if we walk in that light. Let's walk in the knowledge of the word and let God, as the Bible says, let God be God. Let everybody else be a liar. Let God, let his vengeance repay. Vengeance is his. He said he will repay, not us. We stand on his arms. We're his sheep. He's our over-shepherd. Let's follow the over-shepherd of our souls. Let's give him full control. Wherever he may lead, we will follow. I've made a choice to listen for his voice. Hallelujah. Be it in a quiet pasture or by a gentle stream, the Lord will be our guide. Let him be your guide. Hallelujah. Holy Spirit, we thank you in the name of Yeshua for the blessing of the word of God. I thank you for the blessing of the word of God in me to know that this came from Brother Kagan and great men of faith imparting to all of us 25, 27, 28, 30 years ago. And we get to say it today. Hallelujah for the next generation to impart it to them. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.